Y'all come watch this shit show.
We'll see what they have drawn up here. A little bit behind the line. 12 yards needed to gain a first down. And now the Jags defense deciding to call a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Shit. They'll fake the handoff. Now Herbert.
Just get the first down. Just get the first down. Thank you.
And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. The Bengals passing game finding a rhythm. They've got another first.
And I don't think there's any question that this offense is going to need to hit on a few more plays like this. It's been a difficult first half for them, to say the least. And I do believe if they want to get back in this game, they need to start right now. It's kind of like making adjustments. If you try to wait until the half, it's probably too late.
Bro, if he would have fumbled that, I'd have quit. I'd have quit the full game.
Makes it good for a gain of 26 and also a first down. Back to the ground, Achan.
Bro, I can't even run. I have eight rushes for 30 yards.
No gain on the play. It'll be second down. That's a low number for you. Safety roaming
all the way up. That's embarrassing for me.
His ability to trust his eyes and figure out if it's not a pass play and go fast towards the line of scrimmage in order to make that tackle.
And a decent gain there as that takes us to the two-minute warning. They get seven out of that, so they're left with a third and three. Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. They'll run for it with Achan, and he's able to...
I hate how they say his name, too.
Achan.
It pisses me off like so bad.
This is first and goal. All right, Cowboy. What was the cards you said were really fun? The 3-1s, midget.
Mini sprints, micro sprints, what they call.
And down here, first and goal. If it's not there, don't force it. You got at least two, if not three, more shots at it. It's a wise move to get rid of it.
They'll roll him out right. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he is out of bounds here. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. They run with...
Bro, are you stupid? I was about to say, what are you doing? Bro, I almost fucked that whole thing up. I am just not myself right now.
And the lead is down to 24. After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. From his end zone, here comes Agnew.
Tackle him.
Trouble bringing it out of the end zone as he's down at the 27. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. They'll start on the ground here.
Oh, golly, how do you miss that? Bro, Etienne is fucking quick.
What a way to start a drive. An excellent run, a tone setter, and now, if you want to take a shot on second down and go play action and make it look like the same exact play and throw it over the top, you can do so because you've established the run in a big way.
Now the Bengals going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a tick under a minute to go before half. Third and three. Lawrence.
God damn it, man.
Across midfield down to the 45. Now Lawrence on first down. Throw right side caught by Ridley. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. Good work after the catch. Going to net him 23 and a first. ETN up the middle. The Bengals going to use the second of their timeouts. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
escaping the pressure right. That's going to be caught. Touchdown, Jaguars. DK Metcalf. As the first half is winding down. And the Jaguars will extend their lead here just before halftime. Extra point from McManus is good. And a rout is on here in this first half. So not much time to speak of.
Shit talking weird, aren't you, Carl?
As the kicks away.
Fair catch. So we play 2K after this?
And this will be moved out to the 25.
I just saw the message
the
now.
Bengals drive about to get going.
And good thing I got on.
Quickly fading here in the second quarter. Not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much.
Okay, really? You can't even put your feet down?
Get the fuck out of here.
He continues to try to extend plays because he's already been intercepted
fucking
in this game.
Stupid wannabe motherfucker.
They continue to challenge all of his receivers downfield.
Scooter's
oh, thank you, thank you. Good, yeah, give me something. Amen.
Contact may have come too early. So flag for the contact, pass interference.
And I know that you're going to look at me and roll your eyes, and rightfully so, because you know what I'm going to say. Doesn't a defender have a right to the football as well?
No, I don't like defenders.
It's a Tuesday, as long as they don't make eye contact and I wear socks, it's not gay.
Okay, I'll side with you on this one. It's the correct call.
And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30.
Already over 1,000 yards receiving this season. That catch is just going to add to his total. Certainly not resting on his laurels. He's trying to continue to gain as many yards as possible and continue this big season.
Holy shit, you made it.
Shut the fuck up. Thank you.
The NFL on EA Sports. And we welcome you back live now inside the Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, set and
ready. Hey, I get the ball. Woohoo, look at me.
The Bengals with work to do in this third quarter, but they'll get the football first as we are back underway.
Why do you get canceled?
This is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone. And he'll be brought down.
I get that. Why did
he
get canceled?
So the decision to bring it out of the end zone.
iRacing put a big update up. Messed the whole game up.
You kept saying iRacing. I could barely hear what you're saying, Zara. Sorry.
The CD, they certainly know the hole that they face as they begin the second half. They have to do what precious few.
Okay, run forward. Thank you. Keep going. Fuck.
Possession deficit.
And partner, you know, as that team gathers, they're saying to each other, you'd never say never, right? Because if you're on an NFL roster, that's how you have to think. You can always come back and win a ball game. And let's face it, we saw a certain Super Bowl, a 25-point lead late, that wasn't enough to put someone away. But that being said,
so
this
are you getting paid for today or no?
Let's face it, and bottom line is, it officially becomes impossible if this possession is an empty one.
Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains. A great job there, Charles, just to hold on, absorb that contact. I guess that's the risk you take catching the ball.
Oh, this coming Saturday?
It is, and if you're going to gain yardage, you're going to have to go there at some point. But how about the read, okay? The eyes on that play, stepping out from the middle of the field and really making a big hit. Did not get free, but boy, that's a tough area to go into when you're going into his spot.
Nice his way forward here.
See you going to Dave's this week, right?
Second down.
Next week.
On second down, here's Herbert. And this will be caught by Mooney. Only able to gain a couple there. And it brings up 35 now.
Oh, it's time to get real credit there to the defense. He played that very well because it was a drag route. And he ran a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He's hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line. But once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
No!
They're going to have this across the field and inside the 45. A good pickup there on 20 yards.
I forgot you were off
this. Well, they certainly had their share of troubles running the football in this one, but this play is almost an extension of the running game right here. They set up the screen, let him work out in space on the perimeter, and he turns it into a big pickup.
Steps away.
Really great.
Oh, you...
Jaybird. I'm gonna be honest. I looked up Kurt Cobain because I didn't know who that was or what the fuck happened.
You didn't know. You didn't know who the fuck.
God damn.
No. Nobody. We never heard it. Like nobody listened to his music around here, so that's why I didn't know.
never heard Nirvana? Kick this guy out of the cool guy club.
From his end zone, here comes Agnew.
I know, okay, wow.
Wait, so hold on, I missed the whole conversation. What happened?
So, DK.
The Jacksonville offense. I have no idea who that is either.
Oh my god! You ever heard of Nirvana?
No.
What? You're old, aren't you? You're like 40.
Nirvana, isn't that the medicine they freaking, I keep seeing commercials about on TV? That's what he said, Nirvana, isn't it? That's what he said.
It's a rock band, I guess.
Oh, fuck. I wonder why I ain't heard of it. Stupid shit. You know, actually, now that I think of it, it kind of does sound familiar, but yeah, I still don't know who it is.
If you heard their music, you'd know it.
But anyway,
you're probably right.
I had to look up Kurt Cobain when I saw that TikTok to finally figure out what the fuck you were saying half the time. So that's why I tagged you and I thought it was funny as fuck.
Oh, when I said I'm gonna Kurt Cobain myself?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, he committed suicide. He blasted a shotgun through his head.
I didn't know that.
And not willing to You'll know this song. Fumble. He'll sit on this one. It's a touchback.
I've heard that song, but I didn't know
that
was good.
The lead singer of this band is Kurt Cobain. Exactly been treated to a nail biter in
this one, CD, and if they cannot score, is it because he's just tired of life? Then he just
don't fumble, don't fumble, fumble.
There's a whole conspiracy that his girlfriend actually killed him because he was outing Hollywood and his music. And he was about to go off. There's a whole conspiracy that he can't score here. His girlfriend. Yeah, you're right about that because it has been pretty clear who the best team has been in this one. That's right. And in a league that we talk about every game being let's give him the low cheese. That's such a bad idea. But we fucking got him. Sit down. Bye bye.
Not gonna lie, that's not who I meant to throw to. But it was.
But well, anyway, when I finally figured it out and I saw that TikTok, that's why I did you. And I thought it was funny as fuck.
Yeah, that makes sense now.
Oh, that's a play I wanted.
Why am I being tagged and whatever the hell this is? I'm like, this has nothing to do. Oh, backflip is calling.
Now Herbert with it, looking to pass. Oh, canceled him. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in.
Couldn't hang on third down. Oh, nice defensive effort there, providing the hit as the ball gets to the receiver. Separates him from the catch, and normally he's a sure-handed target.
Don't matter, bitch. Got a man open, it's Chase.
And taking it across midfield. Scooter's pissed off right now. He's going to be even more pissed when he gets on 2K.
Hey, you should. Jacksonville territory now. Here's a first and 10 at the 44-yard line. Back to throw here, Herbert. Oh, it's a pick. God, dude! Why am I being so fucking dumb? Really? We're going to let this fat... Bro, I'm don't even know what to say at this point. Really don't. Madden. It ain't even Madden, really. Madden screwed me a few times, but I've really just done some. I've done some dumb shit. Like that right there, I knew not to do that, but guess what? I did it. Like if Madden wouldn't have fucked me, it'd probably still be like 45 or 31.
Since the offense about ready to go here on their next drive. Well, we're still in the third quarter, so there's some
Okay. You see, you hit X twice, and it don't snap the ball, so then you just spam X, and then you get that.
Before Q always plays this game, he needs an admin to help with his abilities. Another one there, and this one taken all the way back to the score. Nice little spot in the
post-game highlights.
So they throw the pick six to get another shot as this one's in the air.
What happened?
I snapped the ball, or I was hitting X to snap the ball. The game has a fucking lag in it, so it's not snapping when it's supposed to. So I started spamming X, and then it snapped the ball and just threw it right away and picked it off, and he ran it back for a touchdown.
Rooster.
Yeah.
You gotta get on Madden to help K-Royce out. He needs those abilities.
Oh my god.
Fuck K-Royce.
Yeah.
Maybe J-Bird can help you.
J-Bird?
J-Bird?
God damn it.
So what are you saying? You dumb
hey, J-Board.
we're not even gonna try to, like, he didn't even touch that guy. We're not even gonna block
gonna
now.
Say, you can help your bitch out in Madden.
I had enough time to do a hit stick.
Bro, he didn't even, like, he didn't, like, oh, we're just, the down lineman, you would think would be a number one person to be blocked on a fucking run play. But no.
What, Deacon?
Face mask? No?
Guilty
okay.
He's gonna have the Bengals first down by a good couple of yards.
Okay, you bought K-Royce in. That's your bet.
Yeah, again, I apologized about that. I said it from the beginning. I apologized about bringing him in. Alright? He fucking got on his knees and basically sucked my cock to get in here. So,
God
I
damn.
In, and I fucking regret letting him in because he started shit as soon as I let him in. So, I'm sorry. Kyle, K-Royce. I don't know, he's probably fucking fighting with Tyndall now. Again.
Is he?
I don't know, probably.
Really? Really? Jamar Chase is gonna run the route and then when the ball throws it, he trips. Really?
He's trying to change his player's abilities.
Yeah, because he's just going to out-fucking-do Jamar Chase on that route. That's yeah. Good. 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 Good.
And for one of the first times all
night, he is going to go nowhere. What? Behind the line. Across the line and to the ball quickly there, Trey Hendrickson. Oh. So now they have to continue yeah, with second enough. And 13 after the first down run goes backwards.
Oh, okay. Oh, man.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
On play action, Lawrence. And he's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a first down. They say he was out of bounds, so a big call there that brings up
four. That's what I'm saying, thanks.
Here's Logan Cook now. And the way this offense has moved the ball, he hasn't been needed here in the third. And they will score.
I'm scared.
A great play there.
Oh, God.
Oh my god! I'm trying to shit up!
No, no.
How the fuck does someone not just like, you know, catch that? Were you trying to take it out of bounds or? are you good, Scooter?
I think he's on the phone. Oh my god. Cute is just playing just like you right now.
Sorry, I was on the phone and I don't even know what happened. I just seen the ball and I was going for the ball. The ball hit his helmet and then you scored a touchdown.
Rooster punted it, and twice Skinner was trying to catch it off the punt. Bounced off his helmet twice, landing in the end zone, and Rooster just scooped it up.
Oh my god.
He had God damn, way to run up the score, Rooster.
Nah, fucking you do it. Get to 100. I don't give a fuck. Get to 100.
No, you take it, Scooter. You.
What the fuck?
I hit you in a woman!
I'm done.
There's no point in it to roll over.
Like, what is he doing? That was not me, by the way. I didn't do that.
He sees ball and rolls over.
At this point, Scooter's like, whoever I face next, I'm gonna beat their ass. That one goes
for 30 yards. And I think Scooter put all his talents on PS5. And here's yet another big play. Boy, both defenses
have just got to be dragging out there because they've been run ragged throughout. Dude, I'm 0-2 right now on PS5 version. I lost to the Jags by 3 points. And I was making smart decisions.
Oh, it's the Saints. Another big game or two in succession as this one goes for 32. When they've needed a play this year, he's certainly been the guy to deliver it. As this season has gone on, he's been awfully consistent.
Did you think about painting walls?
Yes.
From the 17 now, here's a 1st and 10. Back now in Jacksonville. And this is a blowout so far as we get set for the 4th quarter. A very one-sided affair. It's been a nice day for him as a passer and as a runner. One of the few mistakes he's made in this
right.
ball game. The wrong choice.
That was really dangerous throw.
Herbert back to the air.
I'm not even. Another interception. Picked off by Foya Sade and Lurican.
Jaguars are going to take possession here at their own 16-yard line. Yet another mistake after the interception there. And gosh, you look up at the scoreboard. They just got to be thinking this one cannot
Scooter
get
has left the building.
It certainly can't. And also what happens when you get this big of a deficit, you're supposed to make all the right throws, right? You're supposed to try and obviously get the ball to your own guys. But being down this big, you also take even more chances. And in this situation, that hasn't paid off for them at all. On the other sideline, jubilation and laughter. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Calling no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a 3rd down. The Jaguars on 3rd down, 2 for 5 to this point. This is 3rd and 10. Another tote for Etienne. And they're going to get him down well short of the first as he can only get this to about the 19. Call it a gain of 3 and it'll bring up 4th down. Here's Logan Cook now as he'll kick it away for the 2nd time. Take it at the 37. Nearly a huge return as it is still a very good one. 24 yards. And the Bengals will take over in terrific field position. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Firing quickly here. And that's complete. And they're able to get this one past the 30 to the 25-yard line. They'll get
14 on that one.
Good for a Bengal first down. Well, a touchdown here on this drive, it wouldn't really put much of a dent in the score, the deficit right now. But as you mentioned in the past, CD, their coach is probably just hoping to see something executed correctly on this drive before we close out the ball game.
Yeah, and I think that every guy who's on the field has to feel exactly the same way, because if not, they might be looking for replacements. Treat every drive as if it's your last.
If I'm correct, I play Bruins.
Sliding out of the pocket. Touchdown, Bengals. Devon Achan. 25 yards for the touchdown. And the Bengals get a small measure of revenge as they cut into this fourth quarter deficit. Extra point by McPherson, up and good, as they make the score just a slight bit more respectable here in the final quarter of play. After the touchdown,
God,
McPherson on to kick this one away.
You just play on the head. It's fucking awesome.
From his end zone,
okay, I'm back.
And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
I had a phone call.
Pause following the play because it appears a member of the Bengals in some discomfort. The Jacksonville offense set to begin the next drive. And it's looking all the more likely that
straight
win is going to be in the cards. They'll try to run some time here with a 1st and 10. A 3-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on 2nd and 13. And he'll take this up only to about his 18-yard line. Just a yard there, so it brings up a tough 3rd and 12. Run blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the fourth quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it, and the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're just trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz, you're actually trying to cover up gaps, trying to cover up holes so they can't run the football.
Cook now on to punt as he gets this one away. Fielded at the 33.
Bro, if that's on me.
So
really?
Elect to decline it.
And why not? Just go ahead and let the play stand, and they'll take that.
Good starting field position for them here as they come up 1st and 10 at their 36-yard line. Back to throw. Herbert looking deep here for Chase. Oh, a leap, and he will make the catch. Play there for Cincinnati. 51 yards.
Well, he already had a big receiving game working, and it's going to get a lot better here. Defensively, they're fortunate this is not a touchdown, but he's just been absolutely unstoppable, and he comes up with yet another.
That's to Chase. He's got it. Touchdown, Cincinnati. Jamar Chase. His second touchdown of the night. And the Bengals are able to...
That necessary? We really need to do that? That's necessary?
Remember, of course, all scoring plays need to be verified upstairs. And I think they're going to at least take a look at this. Extra point by McPherson, up and good, as they make the score just a slight bit more respectable here in the final quarter of play. Jaguars are going to cover this one up. Now they're down big here in the fourth. They had to try the onside kick. Can't fault them for the effort, at least.
No, you can't at all. And if nothing else, now you've put something that you're trying to practice, right, that you've worked on into a game situation, and now you can go back and dissect it. So if you need it again sometime, maybe you'll find a better way to do it. But, yeah, this game's pretty much done for them.
Jordan Brooks on the tackle. This defense starting to buckle down when they need to, and right now they're winning this fourth quarter, losing the game, but they're winning in the fourth quarter.
And what a fine line it is about what they're trying to get done, because they're down, so they obviously need the football, need a score, but they can't be so aggressive as to give up their edge, their gap.
The ball comes out, but this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same. Great vision there by Lawrence as he scrambles for a first down. Straight ahead, ETN. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
What?
because that dude's 1-10 and he's about to face Cato, which is 11-0 right now.
4 yards on the pickup there as they get back to a more manageable 3rd and 7.
Brandon, I've got to think this offense. Well, he is the Packers. And I know it sounds crazy,
but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations
to the trash can.
Extra defenders in the box coming after him, trying to keep
him
from walking
so proud
down the game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
So that's not a fumble, but the one I had was. Madden logic, gotta love it.
It's because he didn't take 2 steps from the scooter. It wasn't a football move.
They'll take the 3 and they pad that lead.
Yeah, this one's already wrapped up, but you and I both know, if you're an offensive coordinator, you never let up on the gas unless the head coach tells you to do so. And maybe you've actually clicked him off in your headset so you can keep calling plays and trying to add to this lead.
The Cincy offense about ready to go here on their next drive. Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this one pretty much out of reach. And Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things with this ball game, but
one-handed. Wow. Damn!
A big play there for Cincinnati.
That was pretty cool. Yards.
Yeah, I'm glad it didn't really doesn't even matter anymore. But yeah, cool.
You may go off your sheet and use some things maybe you hadn't planned to in this game. Maybe that was one of them there that worked.
He's going to try and go deep again. And that is caught. Well, they're going to see this one to the end. They get a score, but pretty much an exercise in futility right now. Still down big. And McPherson on for the extra point. To the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it.
Oh, he still got it.
Pass interference?
Successful. So still lots of work left to do, but here comes the onside kick. And the Jaguars are going to cover this one up. Fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number, kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time, you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
Now a 2nd and 2. Lawrence running right on the option. Powerful running. Still going. And he'll head out of bounds inside the 10.
Oh no!
Thank God. I hope his whole neck is broke. Fuck Trevor Lawrence. I hope his whole neck is broke. Oh, you lucky bitch.
You know, when this offense gets down here near the end zone, they're going to turn to their bell cow, and this guy's been a touchdown machine all year. Excellent job stopping him there on first down.
ETN not going anywhere. He'll lose a couple back to the 6. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play. So now 3rd down coming up. Finally, defensively, they have a little clip to show positive for actually stopping him running the football.
It's been a really long night for them, hasn't it? So they got a little bit of a win there. But let's face it, the vision that he's had running the football has carried his feet to the open spaces and to big yardage all night long.
They'll try to run with ETN. He'll get this up awfully close to a 1st down, but by the looks of it, might be a yard shy. It'll be a gain of 5, but they do keep him out of the end zone, and now it's 4th down.
That didn't just feel like good defense there. That felt like pride, didn't it? He's already gotten into the end zone twice, trying to get there for a 3rd time. No one likes to have the hat trick against them.
Going for it. Here's ETN. Nowhere to go. Here he lost the football. And the Bengals grab it.
We can come up with a lot of different explanations here. None of them are going to work. At the 1 yard line and coughing it up. No
way.
You
gotta protect that thing like it's your firstborn.
Your firstborn, your secondborn,
your
anyone. It doesn't matter. Take care of the football. You're in a position to go in and score. At worst, you've given up a chance to get 3 points.
They've got his man complete. And now we're gonna get a timeout.
What the fuck was that?
Called with 3 seconds to go in a game.
That's fucking decided. Not having an arm. That's what that is.
But they do not want to give up big plays like that.
They want to finish strong. So oftentimes in this situation, you tighten up underneath in your coverage, and you bring your safety.
Oh, he threw it far that time.
Man, it's caught at the 6 yard line. And a little bit of a consolation prize there. He's into the end zone. Won't win him the game, but they do get the score with all zeros showing.
But some fantasy players are really happy with that score.
Doesn't affect the outcome, but hey, nice job there to put it in the end zone for the final play.
Could it affect other things? Sometimes these types of scores are one.
Oh, and now they're going to fake it.
And well, that was a hell of a game.
It was an exercise in futility.
But was it?
I think trying to get the 2 points, that was for pride for them. But obviously the guys on the other side of the ball had some pride too. They stopped the 2-point play, even though, as you noted, it did not matter. So both teams battled to the end.
So for you're Jackson, in a piss-off mood, aren't
it's an important win for their playoff hopes as they move to 8-4. And they will hit the road next week for a date with the Cleveland Browns. Meanwhile, for Cincinnati...
Well, thanks to this, you don't have me at Talladega.
...as they dip to 9-3. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week.
Well, it was going to be my last race.
Our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Next game, guess what? Charles...
No, last race, because I'm going out of town that weekend.
Where are you going?
Going to Louisiana.
Oh. It sounded like he said he's going to Louisiana.
Who's going to Kansas? Oh, right on.
Okay, I guess you don't want free beer.
Are you actually going to Louisiana?
No. Bitch.
I wish. I mean, it's an 8-hour drive. Like, we go down there if I could one weekend. Yeah, I think your wife wouldn't let you do that.
What the fuck is that? I was about to say, what the fuck is
So you and your boyfriend quit talking there, Jaybird?
What?
So you and your boyfriend quit talking?
For now. Cause his kids were riled up, so he left. And now that he's putting them... Yep. Me. Yep.
Alright, you guys ready to play 2K? Scooter? Alright then.
I would never work a day job. Put it in the safe.
Never know when I'm gonna need that. Came here with my I'll wait till you guys are ready. Let me know.
I'm ready. Yeah, that's you on iRacing.
You gotta be online, Mr. Before I can send you an invite.
Oh. I'm sorry, Scooter.
Oh, I didn't tell you guys. I saw Ryan Blaney at Culver's today.
I hate you.
Yeah. So, a bunch of buddies that I work with, we couldn't fucking decide on a place to eat, so we just said fucking. We ended up going to Culver's, right? And as we're all, it's fast food. It's famous in Wisconsin, but they also have it in the South too, I guess. But they've got butter burgers and frozen custard. So we're sitting at Culver's, and all of us are wearing our fucking blue. Wow, holy fuck, our blue Ford Roush Yates shirts. So we're sitting outside. We're sitting outside because it's nice out. And fucking, oh, you fucking bum. Oh, I thought he got him. Anyway. No, not you, sorry.
That dude keeps saying, yeah.
Yeah, so, we're sitting there, we're talking, and then we look up, and it's freaking Ryan Blaney. He rolls his window down, and he goes, "What's up, boys?" Fucking throws the peace sign out, and that was cool. Yeah. And then he asked us, he's like, "You guys getting your Culver's fix in too?" We're like, "Yeah." He's like, "That's what's up."
I bet you were getting a stick.
Alright, never mind. I'm just gonna go fuck myself. You sound like the type of dude to wear assless chaps.
Can you imagine Cowboy Watch and bare ass big? Skinny ass twig.
Oh, fuck. Fuck you, DK.
That's JD.
You talk about him more than anybody else, so I think you got a thing for JD.
Bullshit.
Talk about him some more, why don't you? Yeah.
How about you and Kyle go fuck each other?
No, I'm good.
That's your bitch.
Sure.
Or just like your taxes, you ain't claiming nothing.
Yeah. Fire, stone.
Saudi Arabia unveiled its plan for a new F1 racing circuit. Check it out, Cowboy.
Fire, stone.
Firestone?
Ice, fire, stone.
IndyCar?
Stone. Fuck! Fuck you! You fucked me up, you stupid fuck! Ice, fire, stone. fire.
Firestone.
Firestone. Fuck you, you stupid.